Guys, welcome to my 2018 contest prep run. And you know, of course, you know, looking back, you know, on that 2014 prep, you know, watching that posing routine and then looking at you know, the second routine, which was last year's guest posing, you know, the muscle's still there, the conditioning kind of fell short in 2017. And let's just say that you know, it's a little bit bittersweet, you know, bitter and the fact that, you know, I didn't, you know, get in the shape I needed to be in order to get on stage and compete. So I fell short of that goal. But, you know, there was some sweetness in last year's prep run, you want to call it, where, you know, I basically was able to, you know, lose a good amount of weight. And more importantly than losing it, the ability to maintain my weight is huge, because that's something that I've fallen short with in years past, you know, coming off of my past contest preps, where, you know, getting into the off season, I would kind of venture a little too far out of shape, and it was kind of hard for me to maintain an ideal body weight. So that was something that I finally got a stranglehold on, is, you know, finding an ideal body weight and basically learning how to manage that. So that was a huge success for me. So there was, yeah, there was some things that didn't go according to plan in 2017, but there was things that did go pretty well, and I'm pretty happy about, and that's definitely going to carry over, you know, heading into the 2018 contest prep run, as well as more importantly, following, you know, my 2018 contest prep run, and you know, because basically I want to be able to, you know, have a healthy and manageable body weight, you know, when all said and done in 2018. I really want to improve upon my last showing, you know, back in 2014. That was my all-time best shape. And now that I am, you know, I'm going to be 4 years older. So by the time I hit the stage this summer, I'm going to be turning 47, which would be 4 years older than the last time I was competitive on a stage. And, you know, bodybuilding, it gets a little harder, you know, the older you get. So it's kind of new territory for me as far as learning how to progress, you know, where I should say an environment where, you know, my body is just not responding like it once was. And what I mean by responding is not so much, you know, from the performance aspect of what I can do in the gym. Like, I can still, you know, lift pretty heavy at times. But the downside, or what I am struggling with, I should say, is, you know, how well I recover from my workouts. And I think, you know, one of the things that was, I think, holding me back, now that I look in hindsight, holding me back in 2017, was I was really struggling physically, you know, with recovery. So I was dealing with a lot of aches and pains, and the recovery issue is just, you know, it was really kind of hurting performance. So my physique just wasn't responding like it once was. So, and that mentally is really hard to deal with. It was really hard for me to kind of, you know, kind of just, you know, as the weeks go by, going, damn, my physique's just not responding. It's not responding. And so a little bit of frustration gets in there. And, you know, when you're a little bit frustrated, you know, your first inclination is to, okay, I got to keep persevering. I just got to keep pushing through this and pushing through this. And, you know, I think, you know, now that, you know, volume is kind of like that hot topic, you know, everybody's talking about, okay, got to do more volume, got to do more volume, especially, you know, as an advanced bodybuilder like myself, you got to keep pushing, you got to do more. So, you know, I kind of experimented in 2017, you know, did a bit more volume than I was accustomed to. And in hindsight, you know, because I took a full week off, you know, during the holidays, you know, I didn't train for the entire week. I had suffered a lower back strain the week prior. And that kind of like, you know, just kind of like had me really thinking like, shit, I keep banging myself up. So, you know, I really need to think about my approach moving forward. And I think what the issue was, like I said, I'm a bodybuilder, a young bodybuilder at heart, you know, so sometimes I get caught up in the fact that, you know, that I think I can still do the same things that I once did. And the reality is, and this is what I've learned, or I should say really thought about, you know, over that holiday break, was that, you know, I have to embrace the fact that I am 46, gonna be 47 in the summer, that I need to start acting like it, you know, I need to start training like it. So really, you know, if I think in those terms and I kind of go back to what was the successful recipe for me, you know, in 2014, where I got on stage at my absolute best shit ever, you know, it was the fact that I wasn't getting out of my comfort zone too much. I was, you know, the volume was, you know, what I can perform and what I can recover from. And I never tried to overreach too much. And I think that's what got me into hot water here in 2017, maybe into 20 as well as 2016. Was just trying to, you know, keep improving and wanting that, like the desire. And I think that's what really kind of got me in hot water. So just kind of like, again, thinking about, you know, the approach, you know, with my 2018 prep, I need to kind of like revisit 2014. And with that said, that means for me, I need to really kind of, you know, tone my volume down, make sure I have enough recovery in there. So, you know, making sure that I'm training no more than 4 days per week. That way I have at least 3 days of recovery time. Because again, you know, I, like I said, the workouts themselves, I can perform the work, you know, still have, you know, relatively good strength. It's just the aftermath of those training sessions. Like, you know, the joints, you know, the joints, the tendons, those types of things is really what's not really responding too well nowadays. So I need to make sure that I'm giving myself plenty of rest. So, you know, out the gates, you know, with this prep, you know, as far as a training standpoint, I'm looking at 3 days a week. And so, you know, the typical Monday, Wednesday, Friday, that way I have, you know, Tuesday and Thursday off, then I have weekends off. That way, you know, I'm recovering from my workouts, and when I do get into the gym, I should be feeling better. I'll have good energy, so I should have pretty good performance. And, you know, I think, you know, a lot of people would say, well, if you're cutting your days down, like if you're lowering the volume down, let's say you're lowering the frequency down, maybe lowering some sets down, which I plan on doing, and I am doing, actually started this week, keeping my sets at no more than three, whereas, you know, I was venturing into four and five set territory on some of my movements in 2017, 2016. So it's just capping it at three. So I know some would kind of like, okay, well, you're lowering your volume down, so, you know, you might regress. And the thing is, you know, whatever, let's say I take off as far as like frequency or taking off some sets, so lowering the volume down, potentially I can make up for that, like improving my performance with the training sessions that I am having. So a little bit of give and take there. So kind of balances out. And you have to also have to think about, what it takes to actually see atrophy. I took the whole week off during the holidays, and when I came back in 2018 this week back to the gym, I didn't lose any muscle whatsoever. Didn't lose any strength whatsoever. So it takes longer than a week of like not lifting to see atrophy. So to think like, okay, if I go from, let's say, a 4 or 5 day split, maybe even a 6 day split down to a 4 or 3 day split, again, if the intensity level is still adequate and I'm getting good performance and that performance is increasing moving forward, then, that's just going to be reassuring that I'm not going to lose any type of muscle or any type of strength. And at this stage of my career, 32 years deep now, I don't need to try to overreach too much, because the risk of me overreaching, there's just not too much rewards, with that risk. So it just makes more sense to me. It's like, okay, just play it more conservative. And like my good friend Alberto told me during our last team meeting, because I basically was kind of explaining this to the team, and they're like, and Alberto's just like, all right, so basically what you're telling me is, you're no longer a deep threat. Now you're just one of those wide receivers that, basically just keeps the chains moving. So you're running these short to intermediate routes and just kind of chipping away and getting these first downs. So that's kind of how I'm looking at this contest prep, is basically just kind of, just dinking the ball and picking up some first downs, and eventually I'm going to make it to the end zone, and I want to make it there in one piece. So that's kind of the training strategy moving forward. So I'll kind of, you'll see, I'm going to go ahead and post up or just kind of show you guys what the 3 day split looks like. It's pretty simplistic, nothing, too extravagant. Chest and arms on Monday, Wednesday we'll do lower body, Friday we'll be back and shoulders. So basically kind of like you could say kind of more bro. So hitting each body part once per week, for now anyways, we'll see how this goes. I plan on running this maybe, anywhere between 2 to 4 weeks. If I'm feeling really good, let's say in a month's time, I may, jump it up to 4 days a week. But for now, I really want to go with this 3 day split to allow myself to get that recovery, to allow my joints to fully recover in between workouts, because that's the issues I've been having. Is just like, I have a right shoulder issue, I have a left ankle issue, I have a left knee issue, a lower back issue. So I have all these little aches and pains, and it's no fun training when you're in pain. That's the thing. Like, I can deal with a little bit of pain, as far as soreness, or the next day, okay, I'm a little achy or whatever, I can deal with that. But actually, when I'm actually in the gym working out and I'm experiencing pain while training, that's not fun. And I really want to make sure that this prep is really fun. I want to enjoy my training. I want to enjoy my prep. So I'd rather, like I said, do 3 days a week and have fun than trying to force the issue and be in pain and not have fun. Most of the exercises that I am performing that you guys can see, a lot of those is based on what I'm capable of doing pain-free. Basically, that's how I program myself. What can I do? What will my body allow me to do? Of course, I still try to pick exercises that will give me the most bang for my buck, so I can stimulate, muscles pretty well. But I also want to make sure, again, I'm safe and things are comfortable. And then lastly, I want to make sure that these movements are fun for me. That's really important, again, to have fun. So that's kind of how I go about my exercise selection. As far as the number of sets, like I mentioned earlier, I cap it at 3. Maybe a couple exercises we might see 4 at times, but for the most part, it's going to be 3 for most things. And like I said, I've already experienced more than that, like 4 or 5 set territory starts to wear me down. So I know from personal experience of running trial and error, looking back at my history, that okay, 3 sets works extremely well for me, where I can perform well and recover well. So that's why I have the volume set, for each exercise, capping it at, let's say, 3. As far as my RPEs or the intensity levels, I've been known to kind of RPs like sometimes 9, 9.5, at times 10. So it's usually in the higher side for me, but I'm really purposely trying to keep things tame here in the early part of the prep. So, you know, not going any higher than a 9. So anywhere between 8 and 9 on most things. And then basically we deload, we just kind of just lower the RP down a little bit, keep the sets the same. So keep the volume the same, but just lower the intensity down just a little bit to get that recovery. This video, I know I'm getting kind of long-winded here. As far as the shows, basically I have my eyes set on a show up in Washington in June, and that is the Wayman White. So Katie Wayman White, who is a tremendous natural pro female bodybuilder. She's won a shit ton of titles. She's promoting a show up there, and she's awesome. She really cares about athletes. It's always athletes first. I just love what she's all about and the positivity that she has. So that's why I want to do that show. It's just to have, because I know it's going to be a fun environment. So I really want to do a show where it's going to be a fun environment. If I do well there, that qualifies me for IP Worlds. And then I plan on doing the WNBF Pro USA, or known as the California Muscle Mayhem in Sacramento. That's basically in my backyard. It's about a 40-minute drive. You know, I did that very first show back in the day in 2009 when it was known as the Capital City. So I haven't done that show. Actually, the first show was in 1999, excuse me. So I did that show in 99. I did it again in 2009. So it's been, you know, quite a while since, you know, I've been on that stage. So I want to be in my backyard, back in kind of like, you know, my home turf. So that's the show I'm targeting for WNBF. And then, of course, that will qualify me for WNBF World. So that's kind of the game plan there. As far as cardio, you know, it's gonna be, you know, 3 to 5 sessions to start out per week. Nothing crazy like list cardio, you know, 30 to 60 minute sessions. I do plan on doing a lot of home remodeling, so a lot of painting, floor installation, things like that I have, you know, on my agenda. So I know that I'm gonna be pretty active with that. But outside of that, I'm pretty sedentary. So I do want to kind of get out the gates with some cardio and to be a bit active. I don't, because usually I typically average maybe 2,500 to 3,000 steps a day. So nothing too crazy when it comes to my activity levels. As far as supplementation, just, you know, simple things, you know, creatine, multivitamin, fish oil, and I like my coffee, so we get some caffeine in there. And then as far as the macros, we're starting out at, you know, 40 fat, 250 carbs, 180 on the protein. And my body weight at the moment is right around 182. I started at 184. That was the day one was 184.4. So protein is right around 1 gram per pound. And I know the fat and the carbs, you know, they're not super high. So the calories are at 2,080. So nothing crazy high there. And again, I'm not an active person. And, you know, my maintenance, you know, prior to starting this prep was right around, you know, 2,370 on my calories. And that basically was maintaining 180 to 184 pounds. So getting, you know, chopping almost 300 calories off of my days, you know, adding a little bit of cardio in there, we should see some progress, which I already have. I've already lost a couple pounds of bloat. And then we have a couple high days. So my weekends, I'll have high days where I'll just bump the carbs up to 400. And basically that'll come on non-training days. So that way the extra carbs there are going towards, you know, replenishing myself. So recovery. So help with recovery, you know, the glycogen stores filled out, give me a nice boost of energy. That way it sets up my next, you know, training week. And yeah, and basically that is kind of how I'm starting off with the macros. And of course, you know, that'll adjust based on, you know, what we're seeing from a progress standpoint. And, you know, I think, you know, out the gates, yeah, we're going to lose a little bit of bloat, so I'm down a couple pounds. But I think, you know, if I can see 0.5 pound to 1 pound a week of weight loss or fat loss, I should say, I'd be pretty happy with that. So that's kind of like the goal right now. And I think, you know, with my timeline, you know, being that I probably won't be stepping on stage until June, You know, gives me plenty of time. And what's really awesome and really love about the start of this prep is I'm starting at 184 versus, you know, in years past, it would be over 200 pounds. So, you know, trying to lose over 30 pounds versus, you know, just 14 to 15 because my stage weight is about 170, you know, 168, 170 in there. So it should be a smoother ride. So right now, like I said, I'm feeling good right now, like feeling really good. The only thing, like I said, you know, just dealing with, you know, a 46, 47 year old body. And so if to think about it, if you think of like if it's a car, like if my body's a car, it's not a brand new car. You know, I can't drive it super hard. And you know, the warranty is not there on an older car. It's like warranty is expired. So I need to really baby this car, basically. So that is kind of the approach and the game plan moving forward. And we'll kind of dink and dunk and, you know, pick up those first downs. And eventually, you know, I'm getting my ass, getting my older ass in the end zone. And when I do get in the end zone, you better believe I'm going to be celebrating and smiling my ass off and having fun. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. A little bit long, but, you know, take care. And we'll talk to you guys on the next one.